Hello everyone, in this video I'll be explaining you how our clothing CMS dashboard works and what are all the various features involved in it. So let's get started, but before that, in case if you're new here, please consider subscribing because we'll be discussing lot of things about our products. So if at all if you wanna have more information about our products, you can just visit us on the website www.ionicfirebaseapp.com. So once you visit the website, here you can see that clothing dashboard. And so today I'll be showing you the live demo as well, how it works and what are all the various features available. See, this is how it looks like. But before that, I want to give a quick introduction about clothing CMS dashboard, why we use basically, what are the advantages. So see here, the Nodejs clothing backend CMS is built to manage a clothing mobile app, but you can use to manage any other web or mobile apps. This web application offers amazing features to manage any e-commerce shop. If at all if you're planning to manage any e-commerce shop, it may be clothing shop, any e-commerce shop it may be, you can use this application, and this application is very beneficial for you. It has a very clean UI and responsive design as well. It is built with Angular and Node.js REST API as well as a MongoDB used in the database. This is all about the quick introduction about the clothing backend CMS dashboard. So I'll be showing you the live demo. So once you go to the website and click on the clothing dashboard, this is how the login page looks like. Once you log in with a credential, you can see here, there are the various features available here. I'll be explaining you one by one. This is a dashboard. In the dashboard, you can access the information, how many orders you have received and how many products, totally how many products, what's the revenue, categories, how many categories are available. Right now there are four categories, so it is showing four. I can show you here. See, 1, 2, 3, 4. So it's showing 4 in the dashboard. So you can also access the sales report. Though you are an admin, you can also sales report for the particular period. See here, for last 30 days sales report is here. This is how the dashboard works, and you can also see the user's information. You can see the order ID, you can see the username, mobile number and what's the status, and you can also change the status from the going to the view option. And once the user order any particular item, you have to just click on status icon and you have to go here. And you can change the status, whether it's delivered, whether it's on the way, whether it's pending, whether it's approved or whether it's cancelled. Based on your convenience, you can choose the status. See, this is how you can change the status from here. And next important feature is products. You can go to products, and if at all if any of the new products available in your store, you can also add it in the dashboard. You have to just click on add new products here. And you have to give a title and you have to choose a category. So I'll be choosing, there are different category available. This category settings can be done in the category option here, and even subcategory also. Here there is a subcategory. All this category and subcategory you can set it from the category. So I'll be choosing subcategory and select the brand. There are different brands available. And select a color, in which color that particular product is available, and select the stock size. And select the various different size, in which are all the size that product is available, and give the price amount, how much it cost. And here you can give the offer percentage. If at all, if you're giving any particular offer percent, you can give it from here. And you have to go here and you have to select the images, and after selecting the images, you can give a short description. For demo purpose, I'll be showing you. And here you can give a detailed description. And once you fill in all the details, you have to just click on save product. see here, product have been added successfully. So whatever the product you have added, you can see it from here. I've added a casual wear. So if at all, if you want to add a variant, you can go to variant option and you can click on add variant and you can select a color and enter the SKU code and enter the price amount for that particular color, how much it costs and what's the stock size or quantity. And you can choose in which are all the different sizes that variant is available, and you can select the images. And you have to just click on save variant. Once you click on save variant, your variant will be, if you go to the variant, see the variant has been added successfully. If at all, if you want to view it, you can go here and you can view the detailed information about the variants. And if at all, if you want to edit it, you can edit it from here. If at all, if you want to add any changes, you can add it. And you have to just click on update product and your product will be updated successfully. And if at all, if you want to delete it, you can delete it from the option given here. You have to just click on delete option. If you want to delete, press OK button. I'll be pressing OK button. So product is deleted, the message is appeared. And the next feature is categories. You can also set a different category. In order to set a category, you have to just go to add new category and you have to add the title. And you have to select an image of that particular category and you have to click on save category. So your category has been added successfully. So if at all, if you want to add a traditional wear, if at all, if you want to add subcategory, what are all the different traditional wear available, you can add here. You can enter the name and you can just click on create. It will be created successfully. In order to edit it, you can edit from this option, and if you want to delete it, you can just click on this delete option and you can delete it. So this is how the subcategory works. And here also there's a view option. You can view it from here and you can also edit it, and you have to just click on update category so that your category will be updated successfully. And you can also delete it as well. So this is about the category, and you can also add a blocks. So in order to add a blocks, what you need to do is here at the right corner, there is a add block option. You have to just click on it and you have to add a title. And you have to fill in all the details. You have to give a description and you have to just click on add category. See here, whatever the category you have added, it is appearing here. This is how whatever the blog you have added, it is appearing here. This is how you will be adding the blogs from this option. So next feature is orders. If at all, if you click on orders, there you can see, access all the information about the users, about your customers, whatever the products they have ordered, what's the order ID, what's the username and what's the phone number and status. So you can also change the status by just clicking on the view icon here. Here you can, I'll be scrolling it, see here, all the information will be present, what's the address details, payment details, what they have ordered, how much quantity and what's the total amount, and all the information you will be getting from this page. And you have to just go here and you have to update the status, whether it's delivered, whether it's on the way, whether it's pending, approved, or anything. So you have to just click here. See, your status have been changed successfully. This is how you can change the status. And next feature is a token or tickets. If at all you can access what is the token title, date, and what's the status. You can also change the status from the view options over there, and you can also see all the details about what issue they have raised a token. See the totally wrong item sent. You can help them out. You can help them out. You can just click on update status and you can choose any of the status so that ticket status have been updated successfully. This is how the token option works. And next thing is payment methods. There is different payment methods available here. I'll be explaining you how it works. Here in payment method, there is a Braintree, Stripe, PayPal and cash on delivery. So if at all, if you click on all the checkboxes for the users, he can pay it either by using Braintree, either by using Stripe, or either by using PayPal or cash on delivery. Either using one of these, he can pay it. If you click on the checkbox of only Braintree and Stripe, he can pay it only by using Braintree. Either Braintree or either Stripe. He can't pay it by using PayPal or cash on delivery. If at all, if you click on checkbox of only cash on delivery, there's a only one option available for him, for the customer, in order to pay, that is through cash on delivery. This is how the payment option works. So once you scroll down here, you can select a Braintree account type. I'll be selecting live or any of the sandbox. And once you select that, here you can scroll down. Here you can select a Stripe environment. And once you select a Stripe environment, here you can select the PayPal environment as well. And cash on delivery and payment in currency. Once you update all these things, you have to just click on update option. See, your payment details have been updated successfully. And next feature is settings. Under settings, there is a tax. What you need to do is, you can also set a different tax percentage, GST percentage from here. I'll be setting 25%, and you can, after setting this, after filling in these details, you have to just click on submit option so that your settings have been updated successfully. And there's a coupon and offers available, features available. You can also set a coupon if at all, if you are really interested in giving certain amount of off, if there is any occasions like festival or any of the seasons, you can give it. You have to just go to add coupons and you have to give. And you have to give a offer percentage and applicable from on which month it's available, from which day it's available, and what's the year, and applicable till date you have to give here. Month, choose a month, choose the day, and choose the year, and click on the status checkbox and give a short description. And you can click on add coupon so that your coupon will be added successfully. See here, I've added a coupon with flat 50% off. So it has been added successfully and valid from this date to valid till to date. And next thing is, you can also update it from clicking on the check, clicking on the update icon. And once you update it, you have to just click on update option. If at all, if you want to delete it, you can delete it from the delete option. So that, see, you can see here, coupon have been deleted successfully. And next feature is, you can also set a loyalty points from this field. You can fill in all the fields and percentage off, and you have to just click on submit. so that your settings will be updated successfully. And one more feature is users. You can also access the informations of the various users who are using your product. You can see what's a name, what's a contact number, what's the email. Once you click on view option, you can see all the details from here. This is how the users option work. And here there is a feature called option. Under option, you can set a various color as well. So any of your product is available in your store only with these colors. Now the new product have been arrived with the purple color. So you can just go to add new color. And what's the color name? You can give here, and color extra code you can give here. Once you fill in all the mandatory fields, you have to just click on add color so that your color have been added successfully. See here, you can also edit it from the edit option, and also you can delete it from the delete option given here. And next feature is there is a size option. You can also set a different size. In order to set that, you have to just go to add size, and what's the size name. And what's the short name? And you have to just click on add size so that your size will be added successfully. You can also edit, and you can also delete it from the delete option given here. So that size, whatever you have added, whenever you go to products and whenever you try to order, whenever the user try to order, you can see that size, whichever the size it's available. See, whenever you go to products, here there is a size option. See here, I've added a size called large. Whatever the size you have configured there, it will be appearing here. So the next thing is color. I've added a color as well. So whatever the color you have added over there, it will be appearing here in here. This is all about the size and color feature. Next thing is there's an offer feature as well. If at all if you want to give offer for any of the occasions or any of the things, you can also give the offer for the customer. If at all if you are really interested, and if at all if you want to like it, and you can go to add new offer, and you can give here what's the offer title and how much percentage off you are giving. And you can check on this checkbox whether it's available or not, and you have to just click on add offer so that your offer will be added successfully. So this offer will be available for the customers, those who are buying your product. It will be 25% off for them. And next thing is you can add a color as well. I've showed you. And next thing is you can also set a brand. If there is any new brand appeared and it's available in your store, you can just go to add new brand, and you can add a brand name, and you can just click on add brand. See, your brand have been added successfully. What if the brand have added, it's appearing here. You can also edit it, and you can also delete it from the delete option given here. This is all about the various features of the clothing dashboard. So if at all if you want to buy it, you can buy it from here. And if at all if you want to install this application in your machine, you can go to this document option, and you can install it by following the steps. We have created the video as well how to install it. If you have any doubts, you can go and watch that video, and you can install it easily. This is all about the various features involved in our Nodejs clothing dashboard. So I'll be concluding this video in here. In case if you have other questions as well, I highly recommend you to post down on the comment section given below, and we'll be surely making your video for that, and we'll be surely answering for your queries, replying back to your queries. With this, we'll be saying that if you are enjoying this video in here, make sure that you'll be giving a thumbs up. In case if you are new here, consider subscribing, and if you think that this video is really helpful for somebody, make sure that you share it, and I'll be surely catching you up in the next video. Thanks for watching. Thanks. Bye bye. Take care.